Joe Tarnowsky was an outstanding basketball player, 7 feet tall, of power like Dwight Howard, with a touch like Ray Allen. He was bound to be in the NBA, but an injury stopped his career. I caught up with him to talk to him about what the basketball players do once their basketball days are over. This is one video every basketball player dreaming of making it to the NBA should watch, because it doesn't matter how many hours of basketball you'll invest, you always need something to fall back on. Joe Tarnowsky was a basketball star in his own right, recruited by every major college. He played for one of the best teams in Israel, Hapoel Jerusalem. He was on the fast track to the NBA, 7 foot tall, who could handle the ball, light it up from anywhere. But an injury, not once, but twice, to his left knee, ended his career. Your whole life, you thought you're going to be in the NBA. You're 7 feet tall, you have a great jump shot, you're built like Arnold Schwarzenegger, and then an injury happens. First of all, how do you adapt to something like that when your whole life is geared to one thing?
It's really hard. For a while I had a hard time, but very quickly I realized I have to do something else.
But it's tough when you're 7 foot. If you're a short guy and you get injured, so your life goes on, but you always have this label that you're a basketball player no matter what, 24/7. You walk into a grocery store, you walk into the bank, you walk on a beach, people, who's this basketball star coming?
Basketball is something that runs in the family. Joe's sister, Lena Podkoritova, was a basketball star in her own right. She played on the Russian national team and also was a member of Elie, which is kind of like the women's Lakers of Israel.
She was on the national team in Russia, and she was a great player. Basketball, one of the most intelligent sports. It's not only developing your athlete skills, it's also developing your mind, your thinking. It's the game itself is complicated.
That's it, no. That's not
really. No, here's a big screen TV.
And do you ever bang your head on doorposts?
Yeah.
All the time.
No, not right now. I mean, much less right now. When I was younger, I was trying to get to straighten up, like to show how cool I am. Next thing, you see me holding my head because.
Any basketball tips, not life tips, for young players? What would you do differently back then than you're doing today?
Be a little more, you know, take it serious. Take everything serious. You playing right now, you on the court. Don't take it for granted.
So just because you're a superstar athlete and you're ready over there, work
right.
10 times harder. Just because you were God-gifted with talent, a size, or...
Doesn't matter, nothing matters. Don't take for granted every moment you're on the court, perform. Give it best. You know what? Some run 100 meters and they get tired and they say, oh, I'm not in shape and whatever. Look at the special forces and the army. They run thousands of kilometers every day and they perform. They take 150% of the body, the human.
To the extreme.
Yeah, that's not extreme. The human being can perform much more than he thinks he can.
Well, what happened? So you got injured, your basketball career came to an end. What happened then? What goes through your mind? Like, what do you do?
I found another career. I was always was obsessed with technology and computers. So I went into this direction. I started to learn everything about computers. I took courses one after another. So far, about what, 11, 12 courses? MCSC, CCNA.
What advice would you have for people when they're young?
Stay in school, that's number one. School is always helps. It's like I said, in that age, the only thing you can do, I mean, being young, is go to school. I mean,
but it's easy to say, but when you're an athlete and you know that as yourself, you practice 8, 6, 10 hours a day of basketball, gym, basketball, cardio. So the people say, oh, Joe doesn't know, he's just saying that.
Okay, let's put you in this situation. Right now, I'm working 9.5 hours a day.
Uh-huh.
And I have family to feed.
Uh-huh.
So I have to carry my family and I'm going to school.
You're making up for what you didn't do.
Exactly, I'm making up what I missed during this time when I have a lot of free time.
Despite it all, Joe says life is great. He's married with a daughter.
I have a great family. I have great work that I love. And I didn't become a millionaire. Like, I wanted to be being a basketball player.
But you lived that life, so you know what it's about.
I know, so. Yeah, I lived the life a little bit.
In Jerusalem, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.